My name is Geoff Mulgan, and I work for NESTA in London in the UK. The first industrial revolution probably did more for human well-being than any other event in history, but in its first few decades, actually was fairly disastrous for millions of people. It led to poverty, ill health, crime-ridden cities, and it was only when after that new social institutions were put in place, public sewers, public health, education, the benefits were spread. And I think we have a risk with the fourth industrial revolution of something a bit similar. In the last few years, there's been a decoupling of technological advance and human well-being improvements in other measures. You can see that really clearly in countries like the US, where incomes have been stagnant for a generation for most people, even as the internet and digital tools have poured through society. So that's why it's so important with this revolution, we make sure it really does meet people's needs. It does widen people's opportunities to live good lives. One of the things which most excites me about the next 10 or 20 years is the emergence of what I call a big mind, genuine collective intelligence. I think we're definitely going to see a flood of new thinking tools from machines, AI, machine learning of all kinds. But we'll find they don't really realize their full potential unless they're harnessed to humans coming together and using their brains, their collective intelligence, to think things through, to make judgments, to organize wisdom as well as data processing. We're seeing around the world some fascinating experiments in transforming really how government is done, how a government taps into the collective intelligence of the society around it. And these experiments are taking us away from the idea there's just a very few people at the top of society who make all the decisions. And the aim of these new tools is that governance taps into the wisdom of the whole society, and often there's many more experts outside government than inside, but also help people to co-create the decisions on the issues that matter most to them. And I think this is going to be key, not just for a classic governance, but also for the regulation of the fourth industrial revolution, the guidance of how we use AI, how we introduce drones into our cities, autonomous vehicles. The more the public can be brought into the debate about how we shape these to maximize the benefits, minimize the risks, the more legitimate they will be, and the more they will actually work in terms of how our cities run. So I think it's really important. The pace of change of innovation in governance needs to keep up with the pace of change of innovation in our infrastructures, in our businesses, in our daily lives.